Hello and welcome to this basic ATS introduction. ATS is the Axway Automated Testing System, which is a testing framework initially developed for the testing needs of most of the Axway products. It is now open sourced, so everybody can benefit from its features. And here we have some of these features listed. Easy to write and maintain automated tests, understandable by both QAs and developer. It is good for different types of testing like functional, performance and UI. You can test separate components or complete products. Tests work on all platforms with virtually no change. Everything works locally and remotely. It has very good reporting system to analyze the execution results. Now we will show you how to create a simple project, use some of the ATS functionalities, run the test and see its result. In order to do that, we will be using Eclipse. Of course, you can use any appropriate IDE. So first we will make a Maven project. We'll give it some artifact name. And here we have a basic Maven project with its typical structure. It even has some class which we can rename accordingly. We can clean up a little. Okay. In order to use ATS, you first need its artifacts. And this is done through the POM file. If we go to the wiki documentation publicly available and scroll down a little, we will see how to retrieve the ATS artifacts. I will copy the dependencies and properties sections and replace. As you can see, we provide a version and few of the dependencies. So now, when I click save, the list of artifacts will be downloaded, and here it is. As you can see, some of the artifacts start with ATS. These are the artifacts which are part of the framework itself. The rest are different third-party artifacts used by the ATS. And now let's go and make our test. In order to shorten the presentation, we'll be using a quick example available at the wiki documentation. So we go back and use this quick example. The example itself contains of three major steps. The first one is a REST call, which will give us the home folder of some user. The second step will send a file over some transfer protocol using this user's credentials, and the third step will make sure the file was received in the user's home folder. So I will copy part of the test. In order to make a Java method a test, it must be annotated with the test annotation. We prefer the test in G1. And we can clean up a little. Okay, when you need to make a REST call, you need the REST client. There is here some constant for the URL. As you can see, our REST call adds some request parameters, and as well we specify the response media type. The response media type is not mandatory to be set, but if you do so, you make sure you will get back the right content. And then every HTTP method like GET, put post will give you back a REST response. The REST response itself gives you access to the response so you can see what you got back. I will use it a little differently. I want to verify the status code is 201. And then as you can see from the response we can get headers, cookies, status code. We can also get the body in some ways. One of the ways is a JSON body, and then the JSON body itself can give you access to the internal properties. So we want to get the home of the user. This is our first step. We go and copy the second one. The second step makes a file transfer. To do so, we need to import the file transfer class. The file transfer class goes over a variety of protocols. We will use HTTP. And then it does connect, upload the file and disconnect. Of course we need a few more constants here. Then quickly. So this is the server IP, the location of the file and the file itself. And the last third step is the verification step. So we will use the file system operations class, which gives us access to the file system. You can do a variety of tasks, some of them like checking if some file exists on that location. Now there is something specific here. The REST call and the file transfer, they go over remote protocols, remote by nature. But you don't have such option when you do file system operations. You cannot simply ask if some file exists on some remote machine. In order to allow this, we have installed there some application which we call the ATS agent. The agent gives you access to that remote machine and you can do a variety of tasks. One of them is this one. The ATS agent itself is a standalone application, part of the ATS framework, but this is beyond the purpose of this presentation. And down at the bottom we want to make some assertion. We can quickly insert it. And the missing piece is those constants. These constants, they will be different for each case. So I will type mine. And the file itself. Okay, and the last piece, I need to touch a little the upload folder as it is not the root one. Okay, and now we can go ahead and give it a try. I will run the test as a testng test because I have installed the testng plugin for Eclipse and see what happens. The test is running. From the testng view we can see the name of the test, how long time it took, and it was successful. If we open the console, there is not much of info there, and of course this is not good and we have to fix it a little. How can we do it? We go back to the user guide, one step back, and here there is a few sections. One of them is the test logging. ATS is configured through log4j, and here is an example of some log4j XML. Log4j is usually configured through a log4j XML. Now, if we have to follow the Maven convention, we have to make a folder called resources and place a file log4j XML. This is the file content. The file must be in the class, in the root of the class path, so I'll go ahead and add this folder as part of the class path, which is an Eclipse detail. And now we can go and rerun the test once again. It passed again. If we open the console, we have some information available. We see our REST client made a GET. Our HTTP client made an upload, so there is some more than before. So this is better, but it could be even better. Imagine you run many tests. How can you parse through this console the results of all these tests altogether? In order to make it better, we use an application which we call Test Explorer. Test Explorer is part of the framework. You select a database, you can have many databases, and then you can have a number of test executions. Now we have to get connected to this application. This is done through the log4j XML. First I have to enable the database appender, so all logins will go to console and database as well. So this is my host. My database name, the username and the password, save it. And the last step is we need to know when a test starts and when a test ends. We'll do this through a testng listeners. So we add one, this is a step you do only once and then it simply works, and now we just rerun the same test. If we look at the console, there will be some more information telling us we got connected to the Test Explorer database. So let's go there and see what we have. We hit F5. As you can see, we have one more execution with default parameters, which is not important right now. When we go in, this is the name of our Java class. When we go in, we can see the name of our Java method. We see it passed. We can see it took a few seconds to complete. And when we get in, we see a number of messages. As before from the console, we also have here the REST client message, the HTTP client messages, but we have one more. This one more is coming, if you pay attention, from another host. As you know already, we check if some file exists on some remote host, and as you can see here, this message comes from a remote host, not from the test executor, which is pretty useful when you have to understand what your test actually did. Okay, so what did we learn today? We learned how to make a simple project, how to use some of the ATS code, and we also learned how to use a little bit the Test Explorer application. This is for today. Thank you for joining. We'll be right back.